Hello friends, we are discussing chemical kinetics, and in chemical kinetics, now derivation of rate constant of second order reaction with unequal initial concentration. So for that, first consider, as usual, last derivation, consider a general chemical reaction. With unequal initial concentrations, and having order 2. So consider that reaction, right? A plus B, it gives product, you can say the AB. Or just write the product, no problem. Product. This one product. Initially means when T is equal to 0, product was 0. So let initial concentration of this reactant A is small a and initial concentration of reactant B small b. It is not equal. A and B are not equal. Where A and B is not equal. At time t, let x be the concentration of product. If x be the concentration of product, then concentration of reactant will be a minus x, and concentration of reactant b will be b minus x. After this, apply rate law. So by rate law, rate of reaction is directly proportional to product of concentration of this a and this b. So that is at time t. So directly you can write a minus x into b minus x. Now here order is 2. So how order is 2? Here I have not written 2. But if two such reactants are there, we have to take the sum of power. So here power is 1. Here power is 1. And 1 plus 1 is 2. So therefore order is 2, but 1 is not necessary to write. Without writing also, it will be there. It is hidden. Like your hidden potential. All of you have a lot of hidden potential, hidden energy. How much energy inside you? As per Einstein's equation, E is equal to mc square. You can find it. M is the mass. Just take that mass, means your weight, multiply that by c, that is velocity, constant 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second square. So that much energy, that much potential inside you. All of you please observe that potential and solve this equation. So therefore rate is equal to k2 into a minus x into b minus x. So we have to find out derivation of this k2. It is your equation number 1. By rate definition, this we have discussed. So rate is equal to dx by dt. This is your equation number 2 from equation 1 and 2. Equation 1 and 2. Left hand side is equal. So automatic right hand side should be equal. Therefore, k2 into a minus x into b minus x is equal to dx by dt. We have to remove derivative. Here derivative term is there. So for that we have to take integration. But before taking integration, here variable is x. So if dx is the variable, that x containing term should be dx side and other term should be other side. So just we'll rearrange it and we'll take the integration of this one. So therefore, now this one I think all of you have written properly, step by step, right up to here properly, and go ahead with observing your hidden potential, hidden energy. So from equation 1 and 2 we have written this one, just that we'll rearrange it properly. Therefore, k2 into dt is equal to dx this will be divide, change party, change symbol, a minus x into b minus x. It was left side multiplied, but if it is going in the right party, right side, it will be divide. And dt, here it was divide. If it is going this side, it will be multiplied. So that is simple mathematics, fourth standard mathematics. So this will be there. So therefore, k2 dt. Now this one, your equation number 3, and I don't want this derivative, so take integration of equation 3 to remove the derivative. Take integration of equation 3, and it is a definite integration. So for that, k2 dt. Now t vary from 0 to t. We are studying reaction till time t. So initially time was 0, so 0 to t. And here another dx upon this one. So we can write this way, a minus x into b minus x into dx. Both are same only. Here just I have written 1 upon this term and into dx. Instead of here, I have written dx here. Both are same. Now x is variable and x is what? Product. So initially product was 0. And at time t, product was x. So limit should be 0 to x. Now we will solve this integration, but this is not simple integration. Previously, you solved simple integration. This is quite difficult. But don't worry. We can simplify this one. Here, why it is difficult? Because 1 upon something multiplied, two functions are multiplied there. So that is quite difficult. A minus x, b minus x, but you can simplify that. So how to simplify? Simplification by partition. So we can do this by partition. So note down, this is your equation number 4, and we have, or we can solve this one. So 1 upon a minus x into b minus x. If one function is there, either a minus x or b minus x, easily you can find the integration. But if such function is there, it is quite to find integration. So for that purpose, we have to do some exercise that is called integration by part. We'll make part. So for that, take some constant L upon A minus X plus another constant M upon B minus X. So that means denominator multiplied this term is there. That multiplied term we have written in terms of addition this way. Now we have to solve the value of, we have to solve this equation to find the value of L and M. So how to solve? I have given the equation number also 5. After finding value of L and M, we can put that value here in this equation and we can simplify this one. So for that, just apply the knowledge of mathematics. 1 upon A minus X into B minus X is equal to, if such fraction you have to solve, you have to take the LCM, so cross multiplication. So L into B minus X plus M into A minus X upon A minus X into B minus X. Here A minus X into B minus X, here A minus X into B minus X. If this term I am taking this side, it will be multiplied. And then this divide term and multiplied term can be cancelled. So I am dividing both here, a minus x will be cancelled, b minus x will be cancelled, and what will be left? Therefore, 1 is equal to L b minus x plus m into a minus x. Say this is your equation number 6. Now in this equation 6, first I want this term 0, then I can find the value of L. Then you take this term 0, then you can find the value of L. But how it is possible? We have to take some value of x. So if I want to take this term 0, so if x is equal to b, so b minus b will be 0. So take x equal to b, therefore equation 6 becomes, so in it, if you are putting x equal to b, so b minus b will be 0, that means this term will be 0, and you are getting after solving this one, see, we have done this one. This is equation number 6. After solving this one here, I am writing what we are getting. So 1 is equal to L into B minus B, 0. So L into 0, so not necessary to write that term. So M into A minus, this X is, we have taken B. So A minus B. Therefore, M is equal to 1 upon A minus B. So this is one important part. You can note this is your equation number 7. Now in equation 6, put X is equal to, this is your equation 6. In this equation 6, I want this term 0. So for that purpose, what we have to do? We have to take X is equal to A. If you are taking X is equal to A, A minus A will be 0 and this term will be 0. Then we can find the value of L. So if we are doing this one, what we are getting? 1 is equal to L into B minus A plus M into 0. So that will be 0. And after solving this, we are getting L is equal to 1 upon B minus A. So this is another important part. Here, one important part. So this is your equation number 8. So this equation 7 and equation 8 have value of M and L. So that value of M and value of L, put in equation 5 and simplify that one. So value of M is 1 upon A minus B. Value of L is 1 upon B minus A. So after this, we can simplify this one and put it here. So remember, value of L, L value is 1 upon B minus A. And so that means what we are doing? So equation, this 5 becomes from this value, from equation 7. So here you can do that. From ahead, below you write this one. So from equation 7 and 8, equation 5 becomes. So this is equation 5, and in it 7 is saying what? Value of M, and 8 is saying value of L. So value of L is 1 upon B minus A. So we can write here 1 upon B minus A, and instead of M, you can say, see the equation 7, M is equal to 1 upon A minus B. So here you can write 1 upon A minus B. You can write this way. So this is, and this one again simplify it properly. So this value we have, we are getting, and we will simplify this one. Because finally what we have to do, we have to write this 1 upon A minus X into B minus X in terms of addition. Then it is easy to take integration. Formulas are there. Therefore, 1 upon A minus X into B minus X is equal to, here 1 upon B minus X divided by this, means what? 1 upon, we can write this way, B minus A into A minus X plus 1 upon A minus B into B minus X. So take this 1 upon B minus A common. So therefore 1 upon A minus X into B minus X is equal to, take 1 upon B minus A common. So inside bracket what will be left? 1 upon A minus X plus, so this, from this case we have taken B minus A common. But here B minus A is not there, here A minus B is there. But you can make it B minus A. How you can make it? So take minus sign, and this A is minus A, and this B plus B. So both are same only. So this is means what? Minus, minus plus A, minus plus minus B. So it is A minus B only. But A minus B you can write this way. And this is what? Minus A plus B means B minus A. Means B minus A. So this is minus B minus A. And plus minus is what? Minus. So it is there. But we have to think that plus minus. Minus. And therefore here it will be minus. We have taken this B minus A common. and upon 1 upon b minus x. So this way you have to simplify this one. Just remember a minus b means minus of b minus a, and that b minus a already we have taken common. So what is left? Minus is left, and that minus is here. And then what is left? This b minus x is left. So 1 upon b minus x, 1 upon a minus x is left, and we have solved this one. So this is your simplification of 1 upon a minus x into b minus x. Practice is required to solve this one, and mathematical knowledge. And mathematical knowledge is just general addition, multiplication, so that knowledge. So this is your equation number 9. From this equation 9, it is simple equation. So from this 9, instead of 1 upon a minus x into b minus x, you can write this one. So equation 4 becomes, from equation 9, equation 4 becomes. So see the equation 9 properly. So multiple term we have written in terms of addition. So from equation 9, equation 4 becomes. From equation 9, equation 4 becomes. Equation 4 becomes. So 0 to t, k to dt. This one keep as it is. And this one also 0 to x into 1 upon a minus x into b minus x is our 1 upon b minus a into 1 upon a minus x minus 1 upon b minus x into dx. So this way we can write, therefore what we can do, let's take constant term. In integration you know that constant term is taken common. Therefore k to 0 to t dt is equal to, here constant term is what, 1 upon b minus a. So take that common, 1 upon b minus a into integration of 0 to x, integration of 1 upon a minus x. We have taken this common constant term, and here subtraction is there. So this integration we can write two times also. So better take this common outside the curly bracket and take integration inside the bracket. Multiply that, because it is integration. If addition is there in integration, you can write two times integration. If subtraction is there, write integration two times. So that way we are doing here. So take this common, then take this integration for this 1 upon a minus x dx, then minus integration of, better write separate way, 1 upon a minus x dx. So this multiplied dx here, minus 0 to x, multiply by this dx to this side, and this one we have already taken common. So integration 0 to x, 1 upon b minus x into dx. Now we will solve this one. This integration we have to solve, and we have to apply upper limit and lower limit, and upper limit minus lower limit, so that way we can go ahead. So we'll solve this one. This equation properly, if you are solving, you are getting your answer k2 into integration of dt is what, t, integration, and derivative can be cancelled and only t will be left. And so integration of dt is t, and limit is lower limit 0, upper limit t, is equal to this one, 1 upon b minus a, keep as it is. Now inside the curly bracket we will solve remaining part. Integration of 1 upon a minus x, so we have that, we have solved this one also. Since this formula, last case we have solved this one, integration of 1 upon x dx is what, ln of x. And integration of 1 upon a minus x is a minus x dx is ln of a minus x But in this case, we have to divide by derivative of this function a minus x. And derivative of a minus x is what? Derivative of a is 0. And derivative of minus x is minus 1. Therefore, minus 1 will be here. So it is what? Minus ln of a minus x. That means what? Integration upon a minus x is what? Minus ln of a minus x. So we can write this way. Minus ln of a minus x. This is integration formula. And this minus sign keep as it is. And here apply limit. Lower limit 0, upper limit x. This minus sign keep as it is. And integration of b minus x. Now b a. Here is a, here is b. Similar only. So instead of a only, there will be b. So that is again ln b minus x. Because both are constant. So you can write this way, b minus x. Or better, if their space is less, we can write again properly by increasing the curly arrow size. So this way, minus, instead of writing there is no space. So I can write here, minus, this minus sign, minus ln of b minus x. Why this is minus ln of b minus x? Because integration of 1 upon b minus x dx will be minus ln of b minus x. Upper limit x, lower limit 0. And complete this curly bracket. So this way, we can solve here. But here again, that sign... Here negative. So many negatives are there. So confusion is there. So better take this negative and this negative common. Then there will be less confusion. So k2 upper limit here t instead of t put t minus lower limit instead of t put 0 and solve this one is equal to take this minus common here. So minus 1 upon b minus a. It will be there. Now, what will be left? Ln of a minus x 0 to x minus ln of this minus as it is. This minus and this minus we have taken common outside the integration. My ln b minus x. Lower limit 0, upper limit x. This way, we are writing curly bracket, already square bracket written here. So, curly bracket. Then again apply their limit. So here k2, we will solve this one. K2 t minus 0 is t is equal to minus 1 upon b minus a into, if you are applying here, limit, or better I'll write this one there above. So properly up to here I think we have written properly everything, all the steps, with observing your hidden potential. So come to the point, k2 t minus 0 is t is equal to minus 1 upon b minus a. And inside the curly bracket, we can solve this one, ln of upper limit x, so ln of a minus x minus, instead of x now, lower limit, instead of x we have to put 0, so a minus 0, so minus ln of a minus 0, so that is a, we can write a directly, this is in one bracket, and another here minus, this minus, then upper limit ln b minus x, instead of x, x already x is there, minus ln of b minus 0, but b minus 0 is only pi 0 because lower limit is 0, so instead of x put 0, b minus 0, so that will be b, so we can write only ln of b this way, complete this bracket, complete this curly bracket, and again solve this properly, so you can my write this way minus b minus a. So ln of a minus x minus ln of a. This is take minus inside, so minus ln of b minus x, and this one minus into minus plus plus ln of b. So this way we can solve. Now in log, or better, this negative sign is here. Take that negative inside again, and again simplify it. And therefore, which is equal to minus 1 upon b minus a, keep as it is, but this minus sign multiply there, so all the negative sum inside the bracket become positive and positive become negative. So minus ln of a minus x, then this minus into this minus plus ln of a, this minus into this minus plus ln of b minus x, and this minus into plus will be minus ln of b. So which is equal to 1 upon b minus a into, now in log, if plus sign is there, we have to multiply. If minus sign is there, we have to divide. So where is minus? Minus is here, minus is here. So this term, we'll write ln one time. Here plus sign is there, a plus something. So is next to this plus sign, next to this plus sign. That means we have to multiply by this two term. A, write ln one time, and ln a into b minus x. That is mathematics of log. If negative sign is there, we have to divide. If positive is there, ln of a plus ln of b is ln into ab. And ln of a minus ln of b is ln of a upon b. So that we are applying here. So here this one, a into b minus x upon, this one will be divided because negative sign. So b into a minus x. So by applying this knowledge, you can solve this way, simple way. So this is your k2. Note down, this is our equation number, I think 11, equation number 11. So this one again you can write another way, k2t it was k2t. So there k2t, take this side, so 1 upon b minus a into t ln of a into b minus x upon b into a minus x. Write this way. So this is ln log. So this is your equation number 12. Again, instead of ln, ln means what? Log to the base e. Instead of ln, we can write log, that is log to the base 10. And if you are writing log to the base 10, there should be multiple factor 2.303. So we have to multiply there by 2.303. Therefore, k2 is equal to 1 upon b minus a into t log of, but I am writing log here, means we have to multiply it here by 2.303 log of in bracket a into b minus x upon b into a minus x. So this is your equation number 13. Now see this equation properly. K2 is equal to, so here constant is what? B minus A. If B minus A is there at numerator here, B minus X. B minus X. If here minus A, A minus X. And multiple factor is A into B minus X. A into A minus X is not there. So it is easy to remember, if A is there, there should be a B minus X. If B is there, A minus X. But here B minus A. Another way we can write this equation, if instead of B minus A, if you are taking here minus common, so it will become A minus B. And if I am writing minus, this minus here, in log there is a rule. If I am taking here minus common, so what will be there? Instead of b minus a, there will be a minus b. Okay, but this minus means you can write either in here, here, or this is nothing but what? Minus 1. So minus 1 is multiplied to log. If such condition is there, multiple term or the term before the log is power of after the log. So that minus 1 you can write, this is what? Minus, and this minus is nothing but minus 1. So that minus 1 you can write here. And if you are writing here, you can make the inverse of that. That means what? If I am writing this instead of b minus a, here a minus b. So a minus b into t, then we have to take inverse of this function. That means we have to write at numerator b into a minus x upon a into b minus x. So this is equation number 14. So see, this is equation number 13, 14, equation number 12, 13, 14. Observe this equation. All these equations are similar only, just different format. This is nothing but this. Just we have taken here a minus b. If I am taking a minus b here, at numerator a minus x should be there. And at denominator b minus x should be there. If b is first, then at numerator b minus x should be there after log. So that we remember. So this is equation number 13 and equation number 14 and equation number 12 are the rate constant of second order reactions with unequal initial concentration. So if concentration is not equal, then equation becomes that much complicated. So that means logarithmic term is there. So this is about rate constant or specific reaction rate or velocity constant of second order, rate constant with unequal initial concentration. So remember all the steps. First, what we have done in this case, first we have considered the equation as usual, general chemical equation. After that we have applied the rate law for that. After applying rate law, we have used a definition of rate. Then we have written equation in terms of definition of rate and rate law. So it is in the form of derivative. To remove the derivative, we have taken integration. But that was quite difficult part, complicated part. But if you are understanding, it is easy part. So we can't take integration of that at 1 upon a minus x into b minus x at denominator directly. So we have done partition or integration by part, we have solved step by step. That is a multiple term we have converted to addition, multiple fraction to addition fraction, and then we have solved that integration by applying the integration rule. And once you solve this one, you are getting this rate constant equations. So this way you can solve this one derivation, practice more and more, then easily you can solve this properly. So thanks to all of you. And have a nice day.